See, we're talking of a certain period in American history. The Depression, hard times, coming out of it a bit, but not quite, our system is not quite solvent. But at the same time, there was a kind of optimistic spirit. There's some sort of light at the end of a tunnel. You felt something popping. And Woody caught that spirit.
I've been a-grubbin' on a little farm on the flat and windy plains. I've been a-listenin' to the hungry cattle bawl. I'm gonna pack my wife and kids. I'm gonna hit that western road. I'm gonna hit that Oregon trail this coming fall.
They wanted somebody to write some stories, get some lyrics about the dam and the river and all that territory. Well, naturally, I remember distinctly, yes, I thought that was a very good idea due to the fact that Woody wasn't working anyway.
Here's a government agency that buys and sells electricity for a business, hiring a folk singer who happens to be an activist, political songwriter, rabble-rouser, singing for activist causes. This is out of character for this agency.
Woody got paid a regular salary, and he did what he was best at. Made up song after song after song after song after song.
They're a-rockin' and a-reelin', 'cause there ain't no water to waller in the draw. I'm gonna grab one by his tail, I'm gonna take him down a western trail, and we'll hit that Oregon trail this coming fall. Now my good old horse is bony, yes, he's dry and hungry too. You can see his ribs three quarters of a mile. Throw the kids up on his back, and the bay horse and the black, and we'll hit that Oregon trail this coming fall. I'm gonna hit.
Well, he says, what sort of songs do you want, Steve? I said, well, the purpose of this whole development of the river is to raise the standard of living of the people here by giving them water and power and navigation and flood control and the whole bit. He said, gee, that's a big order. I said, well, that's why we got you to fill the order.
In the future, in that North Pacific land, so we'll hit that Oregon Trail that's coming fall. I'm gonna hit that Oregon Trail that's coming fall. Hit that Oregon Trail that's coming fall. Where the good rain falls aplenty and the crops and orchards grow, I'm gonna hit that Oregon Trail that's coming fall.
You know, sometimes in your life you're in the right place at the right time and the right frame of mind, and everything is just working for you. And then the few weeks that he spent up here, he didn't spend much time here. He was only here a month. But in that 1 month, he lived and saw more than people who have lived there all their lives and was able to put it on paper. You got to be fairly inspired to do that. You don't just, it's not just your average day's work, even for Woody Guthrie.
Interesting beginning. We had just finished producing a film that I had written called Hydro, just as the war was heating up in Europe, and just as we were getting out of the Depression. And the film was well received. The Vice President took it to Asia, where he had it dubbed in half a dozen languages to show how democracy worked and developing a great river for all of its values for the benefit of all the people. Fox Movie Tone picked it up and distributed it nationally, so they asked us to write a feature film. And I said, if I could write a feature film, I'd be getting $500 down in Hollywood. But the bureaucrat said, write it.
Steve Kahn, who was the first public information officer for BPA, had made a movie in 1939 called Hydro, and he and BPA people wanted to do it again, put out another movie, but this time make it speak better to the common man. I hate to use the phrase common man, but that's what they said back then. And so one of the things that they wanted to do was have a folk singer be in the movie and actually do walks and talks in the movie, show up in the movie and sing from a cliff or under a tree or something like that.
When Alan Lomax the Library of Congress, Folk Song Archives, gets a call from the Bonneville Power Administration. We need a country singer who can make up some songs and get the people on our side. The idea of cheap electric power for the people, something we want to publicize. And Alan said, I got your man for you. And he right away put them in touch with Woody Guthrie.
He suggested Woody, because in Alan's mind, Woody could do no wrong. He was really pro-Woody. So a fella came down to talk to us, talk to Woody, when we were living back in the Southern California, and asked him about going to work and if he would be interested in going up and composing some songs on that project. Well, of course, that's Woody's line, that's right down his alley. So he thought that was a real good idea.
They kind of left Woody with the impression that there was a job. Even though there were no contracts signed at the time and nothing said specifically that said, you have the job, come up and write songs. So the government people leave. And Woody and his family decide that they had nothing particularly to lose, so they jumped in the car and took off and headed north. And ended up in Portland around the 1st of May and kind of showed up unannounced in the office and showed up meeting with Steve Kahn and said, well, we're here for the job. And in essence, Steve said, what job? And figured, opportunity in the front door.
Frankly, I had never heard of Woody, but he had a guitar, and I said, play something. And I listened. I said, Woody, I think you have the common touch. He said, can I get a job? I said, well, there are a few problems. First of all, your political background makes it a little difficult to get for anything over 1 month because it requires civil service approval and all sorts of red tape. But we might be able to get you an emergency appointment for 1 month for a specific job. He says, what's the job? I said, well, first you got to write the songs, and then you got to sing them. So he says, well, what do I do? I said, well, you go in, I'll arrange an appointment for you to go in and see the administrator, Dr. Raver. Don't talk, just play your guitar and sing your songs. Remember that, if you talk, you lose the battle, because he might express some of his opinions about the inequities of the capitalist system. So he went in to see Dr. Raver. He emerged with a sheet of paper, hired for 1 month, $266, I think it was, some such sum. And I wrote out the application for it and got it approved quickly before anyone found out what sort of guy he was. And then that's the way it all began.